The last time we had Damian Muziani in the studio, he was coming off escorting Donnie Wahlberg to a murdered body in Blue Bloods. And now he has stepped up and is doing a show called Revenge Prank with DJ Paulie D and Vinny. So many times I almost called it Revenge Porn until I finally did. But Damian, welcome.
Hey, Steve, how are you?
I'm doing good. How are you now? Now, take me through Revenge Prank. It's going to be on tomorrow night, MTV, 9:30, right? They already had one episode that did very well in the ratings. How did you luck into this, my friend?
Well, before I begin, let me make sure I'm clear on this. There's two episodes tomorrow night.
Oh, two?
One at 9 o'clock and one at 9:30. The one I'm appearing in is at 9:30.
Well, that's what I was talking about. Who cares
sort of
about the 9
shot.
O'clock episode?
Yeah, well, I mean, you know, to support, you know, you want to have a warm-up act, right?
There we go. The warm-up act for Damian Muziani. There we go.
Yeah, you got to have the warm-up act. Well, you know, I'm stepping on up. I mean, I went from network TV with Donnie Wahlberg to MTV with the Jersey Shore Boys. So
there you go.
In some ways, it's stepping up. In other ways, it might not be. I don't know.
Did you get the hang with him?
Yeah, a little bit. Yeah, I mean, you have to because you're kind of working the prank with them.
Right.
But you asked me how I got involved with it. What did you ask me?
How did you get involved with this? Did somebody play a practical joke on you when they filmed it, and that's how you got in the show? Or what?
Some of my performances might look like a practical joke, so that's you know, to here nor there. But no, it was an audition. It's a standard audition. They need actors to be able to pull these elaborate pranks off because you're trying to create your own suspended disbelief for the person in question. So like last week, for example, I can't give out a lot of details about my episode because
right.
It hasn't aired.
No, I get that.
But last week's,
right.
There was an episode where a woman pranked her husband and videotaped it and put it on YouTube and embarrassed him.
Oh.
So his revenge was he thought it would be funny if he told her he was going to go skydiving
right.
And brought her with him and brought her to the landing spot. And then he goes up in the plane, and they push out a dummy that looks like him, and he falls to the ground and crashes.
Wow!
And that is exactly what they did.
And you played the dummy.
Crazy. No. I'm the dummy in real life.
Cut! But, okay, Damian, get ready.
Now, here's the thing. That's a pretty harsh prank.
That is.
But for me, the funny part of the episode was that when he brought her to the airport, the small airport where they do the skydiving,
right.
he's got to leave and get in his diving suit and go through some last minute instructions. So he leaves her in the waiting area. Okay,
right.
Then the skydiving instructor walks in by himself. He's late. He's hungover. He's still drunk from the night before. He's talking crazy stuff, and they're taking pictures off the wall of other instructors that died recently because their chute didn't open, you know?
This is great.
So meanwhile, the woman is freaking out already. Like, she's completely panicked. And then, of course, you see that she's got every reason to be panicked because, you know, the poor guy's chute doesn't open. So that was a harsh reality. The second episode I thought was better. This is one where they were pranking. This woman made a fool out of herself on a YouTube video. The daughters wanted to get her back. So one of the daughters pretended to be pregnant and in an ambulance. The mother rushes to where the ambulance is. They don't tell her anything. She gets in the ambulance,
right.
And they tell her that your daughter is pregnant and she's about to have the baby. And so she's flipping out saying, get to the hospital. So the ambulance.
Right.
The ambulance driver keeps stopping the ambulance. He's got to get gas, and he's stopping for snacks. And
this is excellent.
And she's getting more and more pissed off, with every single stuff. So it's stuff like that. It's actually really funny, and you have to be able to hold a fake reality. You have to be able to suspend, you know, the animation for the person so that they don't catch on.
Right.
You want to be able to, you know, get there, because if you blow it, if you accidentally laugh, or if you say the wrong thing, or you're not believable, and they go, wait a minute.
Yeah,
this is a prank.
This has got to be hard on you as an actor, because you don't have to sell the director. You got to sell real people live. I mean, that's got to be one tough form of acting. And like you said, if you blow it, you know, they'll kill you. They'll all come down on you. It'll be your fault.
Yeah. I mean, it's
I don't
want to
put pressure
on
you, Damian, next time, but I'm just saying.
Well, yeah, no. For me, I've always thrived in that moment, Steve. It's always about putting yourself in front of people and then just clicking it on, turning it on, and just going with it. That's always been a specialty for me. Yeah. It's hard now because with the coronavirus, actors can't go on auditions, and if they're shooting any kind of commercials or specials, they're working the isolation into the script. You know, they're doing a lot of production where people don't have to leave their house.
Right.
So as a result, you have to tape yourself and then send in the audition. And for me, I book jobs by being in person. You got to get me in front of that casting director, and I'll
lay the old Muziani charm on him. You give him the old Damian Dazzle. Yeah, the old Damian Dazzle. Next thing you know, you're right. Next thing you know, he's got the gig. Did you see, you know, the show The Blacklist with James Spader?
Yeah.
They shot the finale because COVID had hit. So what they did was they used the scenes that they already shot and they filled in what they didn't shoot with animation. Weird. But they filled in. They filled in what they had Spader animated. A lot of what they didn't film was animated. And it kind of worked out kind of weird. But, you know, it was kind of like an off-the-wall way to do it. All right, now, there's a difference between pranking and revenge pranking. So explain to these people who are going to tell me their revenge pranking stories what that difference is, Damian.
Okay, so let's just take a prank, okay? Yeah. Let's say that, you know, the old cliche where somebody knocks on your door, rings your doorbell, and you open the door and there's a flaming pile of poop in a bag,
right,
and you stamp on it, oh, the joke's on me, I just got pranked. So the revenge prank would be the next night, that same person would hook up battery jumper cables to his doorbell. And then the kid comes back the next day, and he's extra crispy in no time.
I was going to have you in here, Damian, but now. Dude, best of luck. I got to hit the news. Okay, this is Revenge Prank. It's going to be on tomorrow night, MTV, 9 and 9:30. The Damian Muziani one will be on at 9:30. You got to keep in touch. We got to get you back in here when this whole thing is over and talk more pranks.
Will do, Steve. Be safe, okay? Talk to you guys soon.
You too, pal. Best of luck with the show. Damian's such a cool guy.